Hi, I am Jason Graves, and this time it's Arcana, a game developed and published by HAL Laboratories. It uses the sound font from Kirby Superstar. Arcana came first, so I suppose Kirby uses the Arcana sound font, if you want to be technical. At times, this game's soundtrack sincerely sounds like a Silva Gunner parody that I am too old to understand. Former Nintendo president and programming ace Satoru Iwata is in the credits. Wow! Arcana is a clone of Hiroyuki Takahashi and Camelot's Sega Genesis game, Shining in the Darkness. In both games, you scroll through the towns like some sort of panorama. They're first-person dungeon crawlers. Heck, they even utilize similar wall backgrounds. Both have you alternating between a utilitarian zone where you buy items, save, feel safe, and the head-busting mazes of progress. Although Arcana does feature more diverse backgrounds, and a much cooler font to boot. Shout me out in the comments if you've completed Shining in the Darkness. Shout me out in the comments again if you have handmade maps of Phantasy Star 1. Shriek like a freak in the comments if you, like me, have beaten and have made handmade maps for both Shining in the Darkness and Phantasy Star 1. Arcana is almost a good video game. Well, an adjective I might use to describe this game wouldn't quite be a synonym for awful. This computerized distraction is in actuality much worse than your initial impressions might lead you to believe. My first impressions were of the Kirby-tastic sounds, an outstanding fantasy font, and its resemblance to a game that I like. HAL's name alone should be enough of an indication of quality. I've already mentioned it twice, but this might be the greatest fantasy dungeon crawling font that could conceivably ever exist. Everything needs their own font. In a past life, I used lemon milk because I thought it made me look dignified. These days, I use Arial Black because I'm a basic bit. This game's font does such a great job disguising the poor quality of Arcana's prose that YouTuber Daria Plays RPGs called the writing, quote unquote,
quality,
and the plotline,
quote unquote, mature.
I'll admit, it had me fooled up through the end of the first dungeon. Tifa, your other party member, betrays you with her paralysis dagger. Another character, Ariel, then explains his plan to stop the king from summoning the evil Empress Rimzala, and asks if he can count on our hero's help. The player is prompted with a choice between yes or no. I pick yes because of a natural desire to avoid conflict, and because he seems reasonable enough. The words that follow are mystifying. Our hero responds, "Is it okay, really? Is what okay? Why did we answer his question with another question?" Ariel retorts, "Good, but there's one thing I'm concerned about. There's one obstacle to this plan. His ability is exactly the opposite of the evil Empress Rimzala's ability. The obstacle is you." Then they both try to kill you. How am I an obstacle if I'm agreeing to help? How does having an opposite ability interfere in Ariel's plan to stop the evil Empress? I'm agreeing to help you out! We're on the same team. It doesn't matter if you say no to him either. The same thing ends up happening. Over the haze of a new-to-you game smell, the imperfections you glazed over because the HAL logo and the fantastic font appear all at once. The small typos and awkward phrasing from earlier flash into your mind. For heaven's sake, the first line of the game contains a typo. This is an historic land? Chillingly, you've realized the bone-crunching reality. This game is dumb. The translation is dumb. And you question your own sanity because it took you this long to realize. Galanon has sold out to the evil side. Wait, there's a door! I wonder if I can get in. Take care, it may be a trap. If it is a trap, I will fall into a trap. It's one of those things that isn't really a big deal. Games of the time had plenty of English, and the translation in something like Lagoon, for example, is a million times worse. But in that case, there's no expectations. You know, after playing for about 3.5 seconds, that Lagoon will be abysmal in every facet, text included. With Arcana, you see that it was made by HAL, Nintendo's right-hand company, the house that built Kirby and Smash Bros. You expect more from the people who would go on to develop Earthbound. This is my every SNES progress spreadsheet. You can view it yourself with the link in this video's description. You may notice a column labeled, "Does the plot matter?" For a genre known for being all about the plot, in a shocking number of games, it doesn't. Arcana is no exception. The plot does not matter. You can safely ignore 100% of all the dialogue boxes in the game and not miss a thing. There's a guy trying to revive a god. With this information alone, if you've ever played a video game, watched a movie, read a book, or have been tucked into bed by your book-reading grandmother, then you can fill in every blank. Arcana isn't what I would consider hard, but it can be unforgiving, if you can wrap your head around that. You can only save your progress in towns, and there's only one town per chapter. The game has 5 chapters, which means that there are 5 places where you can save. There are a lot of random encounters, and there's no grace period in between them. You can win a fight. Think about wiggling your big toe in the general direction of progress and be ambushed by 8 bloodthirsty savages. If anyone in your party who isn't your spiritual card in the top right dies, it's an instant game over and you go back to the title screen. The boss fights show up without warning, leaving you without a chance to prepare. You always need to be on high alert because oftentimes there isn't a distinction between who is supposed to be an area boss and who is supposed to be a regular enemy. My largest complaint in the entire game is that when a character joins your party, they come stock with no equipment. Not bad equipment, not unoptimized equipment, no equipment, nothing, nada. They show up nude without as much as a pointy stick to defend themselves. Most of the time they join mid-dungeon. Here's a part where you're 8 floors deep into this difficult area, only to have this guy show up and join the party. Luckily, you've learned your lesson and have plenty of extra equipment on hand. You navigate to the equipment menu and, crikey, he can't equip any of it. Now you're faced with a tough decision. Do you try to keep going with one of your party members being essentially a louder piece of luggage? Or do you warp back to town so you can buy him all the shit that he needs? This almost sounds like a difficult dilemma until you remember that if he dies, you get a game over and lose all the experience points, all the money, and all the progress you've made up until this point. If he doesn't have any armor, he will die in 1 or 2 hits. This alarmingly forces your hand. You'll go back to town and trek all the way back through the dungeon after buying him his life insurance. Arcana also has an elemental system. The enemy's elements are represented by the color of their cards. Oh yeah! This game has a playing card motif. Every character is represented by a card. When your elemental spirits die, their card is torn in half. You can repair them in the fortune teller's shop. Gee, I wish she could restore my spirit like that. You can also buy cards from the same fortune teller and use them as consumables in combat to cast spells. Early on, they feel like an in-game cheat code. You essentially have access to every level 3 AoE elemental spell from the opening credits for next to no cost. Around 2/3 of the way through, the entire system becomes entirely irrelevant because the system never advances beyond what they give you access to at the start. Keep in mind, you're not building a deck of cards, which would have been much more interesting, but you select from a list of cards that you brought and they act as a stand-in for spells. Arcana is a game that almost everyone seems to have forgotten about. There aren't many videos about it here on YouTube. The one that I just made, and the one that you just watched, is by a large margin the most in-depth piece, which is saying something because I really didn't go that in-depth. And, At the end of the day, if Arcana looks cool to you, then play it. Or alternatively, you could always just play Shining in the Darkness instead. Or not! That's just what I say. You know what else I say? Never trust anyone who needs a haircut. See you next time.